Teacher Daisy. Today, I'm going to teach you Asas Sains Komputer Chapter 4.2. I will explain this subject in English and Malay. However, the exam is using Malay, so you need to remember the terms in Malay. Let's start now. In this chapter, you will learn Papan Cerita, HTML, and finding the ralat of HTML. Besides that, you will also learn how to build Laman Sesawang yang interaktif. First, let us look at Kod Arahan HTML. What is HTML? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It is developed by Tim Berners-Lee in 1990, and it is used to build a Laman Sesawang. HTML helps internet users communicate with other internet users on the World Wide Web, and it is supervised by the World Wide Web Consortium. HTML code can be typed without any specialized programming software. It can be written using Notepad. HTML files are saved with .html or .htm sambungan. The example of Kod Arahan HTML is like this. When we run the Kod Arahan HTML in pelayar web, for example in Microsoft Edge, Google Chrome, or in Internet Explorer, will be look like this. Before we learn to write Kod Arahan HTML, let us learn the Papan Cerita first. Papan Cerita is a series of sketches that illustrate the content for every screen display of a Laman Sesawang. Papan Cerita can provide a visual representation to programmers and are used to illustrate the design and layout of the interface for each display. Besides that, Papan Cerita will determine the navigation flow of a Laman Sesawang. The benefits of drawing a Papan Cerita are: first, know how many Laman Sesawang needed. Second, know the information that should be included in the Laman Sesawang. Third, provide a rough explanation of the structure of a Laman Sesawang. Fourth, know the flow between Laman Sesawang. There are four structure Papan Cerita. First, structure linear. Second, structure cabang. Third, structure roda. Fourth, structure hierarchy. The steps to draw a Papan Cerita is as below. First, gather all the required information. For example, text, images, audio, and graphics. Second, organize all information by topic, from general to specific. Third, specify the main title, subtitle, and content for each page. Fourth, plan the structure of maklumat and pautan laman sesawang. For example, structure linear, structure cabang, structure roda, or structure hierarchy. Fifth, design menu structure. 6. Plan the look and design of the site. For example, color scheme, height, size, and color of the text. 7. Sketch the link flow for all pages in the Laman Sesawang. After learning the Papan Cerita, it is now the time for HTML. Actually, we use the Papan Cerita and then code in HTML to create a Laman Sesawang. But first of all, let us learn HTML tags. HTML tags are not case sensitive, which means both uppercase letter and lowercase letter are also acceptable. HTML tags are in pairs, starting with this and ending with this. Actually, HTML code is just like a human, got head and body. Inside the head can put title, which will show in the tab of a pelayar web. And body is for all the content of the Laman Sesawang. Paragraph headings tag. The paragraph heading text is to instruct layar web to display heading text of a certain size. There are H1 to H6 text, where H1 is the largest title, followed by H2, H3, H4, H5, and lastly, H6. For Laman Sesawang, there are also sepanduk web, bingkai, and menu that used to attract users to visit the Laman Sesawang. Let us understand them one by one. First, sepanduk web. Banner. Banners are usually rectangular in shape and are located either at the top, bottom, or on the side of the Laman Sesawang. Banners can exist in the form of statics, animations, or links, and contain text, graphics, animations, and sound. Banners are used for advertising a product. Second, bingkai, frame. Frames can be in the form of horizontal, vertical, or a combination of both. Frames are used to divide the Laman Sesawang display into different sections, such as main menu, links, news, and so on. Frames make user easier to navigate while visiting the Laman Sesawang. Third, menu. Menu are quick links to other parts of the Laman Sesawang or to other Laman Sesawang in the same tapak Sesawang. Menu make it easy for users to navigate between Laman Sesawang. There are several types of menu in HTML. Number 1, menu senarai pautan static links. It is in the shape of a horizontal or vertical, like a menu bar in an application program. The static link list menu is a list of hypertext links to other destinations in the Laman Sesawang. Number 2, menu jenis jadual bawah, drop-down menu. The shape is like a menu bar, but when this menu is clicked, a box listing the various options will appear. Number 3, menu pelbagai tingkat, multi-level menu. Table type menu shape, but each option in the table can be expanded to other options, making it growth multi-story. Number 4, menu terapung, floating menu. It is in the form of a static on the Laman Sesawang. This menu does not move along the tatal. It is useful as a navigation element in a Laman Sesawang. A combination of several HTML tags is used to build the menu. Defines a navigation link. Defines an unordered list. Defines a list of items. Pautan text and image in HTML. Pautan text and image are used as navigation tools within the same tapak Sesawang or between several tapak Sesawang in the same or different tapak Sesawang. The HTML pautan text used is A. The HTML tag for a pautan text is like this. The HTML tag for a pautan image is like this. Images also can be inserted into a Laman Sesawang using HTML. There are three types of image formats commonly used in HTML: GIF, JPEG, and PNG. First, GIF. GIF is suitable for use in the World Wide Web. It enables to cross platforms, which means can be seen in almost all computer systems. It enables to support animations. GIF image can up to 256 colors only. Second, JPEG. JPEG is cross-platform format. It supports a full color spectrum of 16.7 million colors. The file format is compressed, so the image quality is low. Third, PNG. PNG is a compressed bitmap file format. The image quality is high, but has no animation capabilities. Tag IMG is to put image in Laman Sesawang. Attribute SRC here is to write down the image name. The ALT attribute is used to display text if the image cannot be displayed due to certain factors, such as no internet network or cannot find your image. The style, width, and height attribute are used to define the size of the image. There are two ways to define image size. A. Use the style attribute. B. Use the width and height attribute. Next, let us run pull down menu. Pull down menu are also known as drop down menu, drop down list, and drop down box. The pull down menu stores a list of items that will appear when the user clicks on it. The select tag is used in HTML programs to generate pull down menu. The option tag is inserted in the select tag to indicate the types of options available. Pull-down menu serves as an optional tool to make it easier for users to enter data and can prevent users from entering inaccurate information or spelling mistakes. After that, we will learn Ruang Komen. The Ruang Komen in the Laman Sesawang is intended for visitors to provide feedback. Visitors can give their opinions in the form of text in the Ruang Komen. The form tag and text area tags are used to construct the comment space and are placed in the body. The size for the text area space can be set using the codes and rows attributes. Text area can hold an unlimited number of aksara. The following shows the writing of HTML text to build a Ruang Komen. After learning all the text in HTML, let us now learn the steps of finding ralat in HTML. First, test run the program. Open the HTML file using a pelayar web. Second, compare Laman Sesawang display by pelayar web with what is expected. Identify the ralat. Third, review the HTML codes. Fourth, fix ralat in HTML program. Then go back to step 1. Let us now learn to create Laman Sesawang yang interactive. A domain is a group of computers and devices in an administered network as a unit and have the same rules and procedures. Domains are defined by alamat IP or internet protocol. A domain name is used to identify one or more alamat IP and is used within URL to identify a Laman Sesawang. A tapak sesawang is a collection of www files of worldwide web files with one Laman Sesawang utama known as the homepage. In the homepage, there are pautan to other Laman Sesawang. Features of Laman Sesawang yang interactive. Allow visitors to interact with the content available on the Laman Sesawang. Allow visitors to post comments through the Ruang Komen. Allow visitors to navigate by clicking on the pautan provided to other tapak sesawang. Allow visitors to listen to the audio. Allow visitors to watch videos. The steps to build an interactive Laman Sesawang. First, select the topic and title of the Laman Sesawang. Second, gather information. Third, launch the Notepad application software. Fourth, visit the Laman Sesawang you have built. Fifth, fix ralat if any. Sixth, surf the internet. Seventh, upload a file. Eighth, visit the complete Laman Sesawang.
If you find this video is helpful, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And if you got any question, can comment below. Thanks for watching.